Gwladys, aka That's Your Hair, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, make sure you tap that subscribe button, hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you've been rocking with me for a minute, what's up, what's good, and welcome back. Hey y'all, I know it's been a hot minute since I've done an actual wig review. Thank y'all so much for your patience. And also thank you so much for the support that you all have been giving me over this time that I've been away. I did drop a video last week explaining my absence and I just received an outpour of love and support from you all. So thank you so much. If you missed that video, you can check it out above in the cards or you can check it out in the description box after this video. So today, we just gonna dive right in. Cause it's been a minute and I miss y'all. And I miss playing in some hair. Y'all saw the title though. You know what this is. This is Outre NEESHA. And we have NEESHA 208. Yes, y'all, Outre is keeping the NEESHA train going. Choo choo, all aboard. We are here. In case you are brand new to wigs, this Soft and Natural series was super popular starting in 2019 because it's based off of a wig that was very popular some years back, Outre NEESHA. So because of that, they decided to come back 4 years later and create the Soft and Natural series. I have tried all the NEESHAs that have come out thus far. I actually created a playlist for it. So if you want to check out my other reviews, you can see them in the description box. Also for my new beginner wig wearers, I do have a video showing how to make your wig look natural featuring Outre NEESHA 204. Very step-by-step detailed video, check it out as well. But let's get into Miss 208, honey, okay? And let me know down in the comments how you feel about the new NEESHAs, if you've tried them already, if you're going to try them, please let me know. So as far as the specs, it comes with your two combs in the front, comb in the back, adjustable straps. It has a very thick, kinky, straight texture, and this style, as you can see, is curled. I would say the length is pretty long, probably like a good 26 inches on my 5'3 frame. I have NEESHA 208 in the 1B color, but this line, which is what I love about this line, comes in a slew of colors. And I feel like Outre does colors so well, especially for textured wigs. And you can see on this care card here, you can see the last NEESHAs that have come out. And you can see that they added some new colors. They have gray colors now, which I think is really inclusive for people who have gray hair or who just like gray hair. I'm gonna tell you right now, Miss NEESHA 209 that came out with this last batch, not interested. The top part is definitely giving me filler hair city, and I just can't with the filler hairs in 2021. I just cannot. But I would love to see it on someone else with my wig base to see who reviews her. But today I'm featuring Miss 208. I do have 207 and I'll be featuring that in another video. So let's just dive right into the pros of this unit. The obvious pro to me is definitely the texture of this unit. A lot of you know that I adore yakky texture, kinky straight texture, blowout texture units, ones that mimic 4B, 4C hair, straightened. I love it. So this feels pretty nice to me. Honestly though, it's not the softest. I feel like Outre has come out with softer textured hair, but it's still soft enough. It doesn't feel crunchy or dry or like cheap Kangalon fiber. So I would still say they did a good job on the texture. Now, outside of the texture, that was like the main pro for me. Everything else is like either so-so or a con. So let me just explain, okay? Because y'all know I stand for the Soft and Natural collection. And I had high expectations for 208 because she just looks so damn pretty. But she's not quite meeting my expectation. So I'll start with the style. Like on camera, I think I look fabulous. I think she looks good. But I'm very particular about my curls, y'all. If you haven't noticed, I am, okay? I feel like the curls on this unit, it's just like three different things going on. So we have this swoop here, which is cute. I would actually trim this a little bit to make it more of a bang, but that's fine. And then we get down here, right? You see me standing up, and the curls just start falling. I think that was purposeful because I feel like they were going for like this bedhead curl look with this unit, which I'm not against because I like the bedhead look, but I think it's just not what I wanted for this unit. I literally thought all the curls were gonna look more like this here. I thought I was gonna see this throughout the unit, and I'm just not. these curls right here on the bottom are already kind of falling. It's just not the style I wanted, honestly. So I'm a little disappointed by that. And I know some of you are gonna be like, oh, but she looks really pretty. I mean, she's cute. Just not the style I wanted or expected. Also, with the construction of this unit, I would say it's decent, but the cap itself isn't like the most big head friendly. I did shift this wig to the side because in the middle I just wasn't feeling it. And you'll see here, that's why you see this tab sticking out over here. But when it was in the middle, I wouldn't say it was coming ear to ear or anything. But I noticed something about the lace. The lace is like giving me like almost like hard lace action from back in the day. And I was like, hold on, am I wearing the old Neesha? Like, what's going on? What's happening, Outre? I don't know. I've gotten used to soft lace, and you know, there's that. But if this lace feels scratchy, like even this right here, because I shifted it, it's kind of bothering me, but it normally doesn't feel hard. I wouldn't say it's totally hard lace, but it's like that in between, and I just haven't felt that in a while. I will say though, I used to like hard lace back in the day because it really laid flat at the parting space. And I feel like this is what we're getting here. The parting space is laying super flat. And I really didn't have to use my Got to Be Glue gel for that. So that's a pro. But it just kind of took me back a little bit when I felt the scratchiness from the lace. Of course, this is a synthetic unit. So even though it feels soft, it's long synthetic hair. And it's still winter time. It's still cold where I am. So people are still wearing different cotton blends and other types of sweaters and fabrics that definitely do not go well with this hair. This is definitely like wintertime hair. Just know that this hair rubbing against certain fabrics is going to wear on the hair and it won't last as long. The way these ends are looking right now, you can expect this to fray up pretty quickly. And normally what I like about textured wigs is that they last longer, but this unit, I don't anticipate it lasting as long as other textured units I've tried, if that makes sense. But that's all I have for Toy. I think right now I feel cute in her, but I'm just not feeling what happened with the curls. I just feel like Outre started off fine up here and then just kind of let them drop towards the bottom, and I really wanted a more consistent curl. But that's just me. Please let me know what your thoughts are down below. Even though this unit is not my favorite, overall Outre still hands down wins when it comes to textured hair, in my opinion, down to the cap construction, the color, the way it feels, everything. But this one, I don't know, with this one they could have ran this by their boss one more time before they put this out. I have a feeling that I'm gonna like 207 better because it's just a straight style and Outre does that well. So we'll see when I review that one. Oh, but you wanna know a wig that I do love? Okay, if you want a style similar to this, but better, Sensational Angel Face. That wig is absolutely gorgeous. My God. Ah! That wig was in my video for my top synthetic wigs of 2020. I felt like such a bad ass bitch in that wig. Your girl was out here getting her rent paid in that wig. You feel me? I love Angel Face. She's gorgeous. I would definitely buy that over this wig over here. Just letting y'all know in case you all are looking for a style similar to this. This also somewhat resembles Sensational Leticia as well, but Leticia is a 13x6 frontal. I reviewed that unit. It honestly got on my nerves. The ending style was beautiful, but it still annoyed me. Sensational Angel Face hands down wins, and it's only like $29. Yeah. This is supposed to be about Outre 208, but I don't know. Angel Face just gives me life. But yes, y'all, let me know how you feel about Neesha 208 in the comments down below. How do you feel about what I said? Have you tried her? Will you try her? Let me know. And of course, if you are new here, make sure you tap that subscribe button, hit the notification bell, because we have lots more slays coming up. I know I've been gone for a minute. Make sure you check out my video where I explain where I've been and what's been going on with me. I discuss some of the struggles I've been dealing with as a content creator. And for my fellow content creators out there, you already know what I'm talking about. talking about, but I just wanted to open up and let my YouTube family know what's been really good. And if you want to see me in more textured wigs, make sure you check them out over here in my textured wig playlist. And if you want to see my latest video, check it out right over here. Thank y'all so much for joining me, and I will see you in the next one.